In this section, we're going to cover pressure profiles and the width tool. So far, we have been playing around with the pen tool and the stroke width. So right now, I've got an open curve, just this outline. I can go up to the stroke panel and I can play around with the width like this. But it's all uniform. It's all the same line weight, isn't it? But how do we make it, let's say, skinny on each side and then fat in the middle? Well, this is where pressure profiles come in and also the width tool. And technically, both those things I've just named do the same job, but I want to show you the different scenarios where you can use them. So just to let you know, pressure profile is under the stroke tab up here, and it's just this little one down here called pressure. And the width tool is over there on the left-hand side in the tools panel. Let's start off with pressure profiles. So with my curve selected, I'm going to go over to pressure and I'm going to click on it once. You can see this little graph has appeared. And if I just click this one and drag it down, you can see it's doing exactly the same thing as the stroke width was. So what else can we do? Well, if you click once on the left-hand side, you see the color changes slightly, and then you can just drag this one down. And you see it's gone thin on the other side over there, and I can drag it back up. And if I go ahead and click on this side here, you see right now it looks like there's a little dot in the middle. If you click once more, that goes away, and then you can drag it down, just that side. Another quick way of doing that would be to just hold down Option, click, and drag, and then you could just drag it immediately. So what else can we do? Well, you can add extra nodes, or pressure points, I should say. So in the middle, I'm just going to click once, and I've added a pressure point. So now I can drag down, and you see both the left and right side have gone skinny. So if you look at this graph, the left side of the graph is like the left side of this stroke, and the right side is like the right side of the stroke. So it works kind of in unison as we drag it up and down. But you don't have to end it there. You can keep adding more. So I've added another couple there, and I'm going to be adding another couple here as well. And we can see what that will do for us. So you can see it's looking a lot different than what it originally looked. And you can play around with that as much as you want, the pressure profiles. And if you actually like one of these pressure profiles, you can go ahead and press save profile, and that will just be under there. And then you could just click on it every time you select a new curve, and it will have this kind of style on it. So I'm just going to press reset. So that works pretty well for this. But what happens if we use this pressure profile on a closed curve like this? Well, basically, when I click on the pressure profile, I have the wave selected now. Wherever you started drawing your first node, and remember, we started drawing it from the left side, and then we went all the way around, and then it ended here. So I know that this is the kind of starting node. So when I go ahead and drag this side down, you can see that it's starting to become thin just on this side here. And it doesn't look good right now, does it? So if we add a pressure point in the middle and then we go drag it down again, we can see that the thinnest part is here, and that's where we first started drawing the wave. So that was our first node we jotted down. Right now it also doesn't look too good, so I'll just bring that up a little bit. And let's say I want to really work on this area here. I have to kind of guess where the thickest bit is. So if I click on this bit here and make it thicker and maybe that thinner, I know that that is the location of there. And it can get a little bit tricky if I just wanted that point to be completely skinny. So it's not always good in all scenarios to use this pressure profile. We could go ahead and add that pressure profile we saved before from the line above and click it, and this is what that will do. Okay, I'll just press reset, as that didn't look too great.